Hello, welcome to your weekly reading here at Soulprint. It's time for you to pick your crystal. All right, so what do we have here? We're calling this one green. Smoky quartz, black. Rose quartz, pink. Okay, so just take a moment. See which crystal or crystals resonate with you. Sometimes all three will have a message for you. And sometimes just one. Okay,
get started.
Here we go. Ace of Pentacles, Fool, Ace of Swords, the Sun. Good Lord. Wow, like nice cards. Okay, so Ace of Pentacles, right? I mean, this is about the start of successful ventures. It can be some sort of important documents coming your way. Pentacles are about material possessions like, you know, life, finances, property, assets, tangible things. The Fool is about sort of taking that leap of faith and starting a journey, right? The Fool is, as you know, the very first card in the higher arcana of the tarot. So what it's talking about, that beginning, that fresh start. But sometimes it's one of those like plug your nose and jump in kind of fresh starts. And sometimes it feels a little bit more controllable. But there's definitely an energy just of new beginnings and new starts and fresh ideas. And it's the energy from these cards is absolutely, absolutely lovely. Okay, you also have the Ace of Swords here. So swords, they're about the intellect, about analytical thought. They're about challenges. They're about conflicts, the law. So with the Ace of Swords, you're looking at triumph over adversity, inner strength, mental clarity, legal matters, and the Sun. The Sun is everything in all of it, right? The Sun is the ultimate happiness, sense of contentment, sense of peace, sense of accomplishment. So I don't know what you got going on here, but you've got two powerful aces that are talking about abundance and new beginnings, moving forward. You have the Fool basically saying, It's time to take that leap of faith. It's time to evaluate where you are, what you're doing, and figure out what your next step is. And the Sun is reminding you that if you hold positive intentions, you can create new beginnings. So it's really important that you acknowledge that for whatever reason, in whatever area of your life, but there is some sort of a new beginning here, a new start, a fresh start. You have to make sure that you're ready to take that leap. But know that the future for you looks very, very, you know, content and peaceful in all ways, right? The Sun represents tangible, emotional, intellectual, physical, abundance, success, happiness. Really nice cards. Okay, let's look at the Smoky Quartz. Knight of Pentacles and the Knight of Cups, the Star and the Five of Cups. Okay. The Knight of Pentacles and the Knight of Cups. Let's just see. So very often, the Knight of Cups may bring you love proposals. Sometimes it's about being really romantic. Sometimes it's about receiving news that is very emotional, happy, emotional kind of news, things moving forward. The Knight of Pentacles is bringing you positive outcomes. It's about movement coming towards you, having to do with assets, tangibles, whether you're, you know, looking for a promotion or you got some sort of a bonus, or there's some new venture that's getting started. But you're sitting here with the star, and the star is about, you know, making those dreams come true, making those wishes come true, trusting that you can bring towards you all the good and the blessings that, you know, you're looking for. The Five of Cups is interesting sitting here at the tail end, because in some ways the Five of Cups, which is about, you know, feelings of being disappointed, let down, betrayal, having regret. It's a very interesting card to finish this off with, but I want you to know that the card actually belongs here. Okay, this is the beginning, not the end. So what the cards are saying is, once you sort of move past the hurt, once you move past the sense of either failure or someone failing you, or there being some sort of a loss and grief, once you got that into perspective and moved beyond it, what you're going to find, or what you're now finding, is that you have movement in terms of not only tangible assets, but emotional assets. So the physical and the emotional seem to be coming together to creating a new energy, a new beginning, a new movement forward, having to do with you wanting to fulfill some sort of a dream or a wish or a goal. So the trick was to move past it and start new. And if you're still stuck in this place, that's okay. Finish your healing, but know that there are good things waiting for you as you move through this Five of Cups energy, this sadness. And in court. Okay, Three of Pentacles, the Empress, Strength, Eight of Wands. I have to say, all of the readings so far this week have been very exciting and sort of uplifting, and they have a lovely energy of success and happiness. Okay, so we've got the Three of Pentacles, the Empress, Strength, and the Eight of Wands. What are we looking at here? Well, the Three of Pentacles very often talks about sort of like with the support, with the help of others. It's about success. It's about, you know, doing the work, receiving the gift, doing, you know. But the Three of Pentacles is also about masters, somebody who has mastered a skill set, or returning to a master. So very often this card will come up if somebody needs to actually refer to a specialist, whether it is, you know, a doctor, a lawyer, a accountant, a jewelry maker, whatever it is, there's that feeling of going to somebody who has knowledge in this area. The Empress and Strength are so fascinating close together, because the Empress is about new beginnings, growth, potential, new ideas, new starts. Strength is about being able to manage the beast, all right? It's about being able to stay strong to who you are and what you are, and not let energies that are not helpful to you get in the way. It's about taming those, tamping them down, and getting your emotions and your energies and your thoughts to work with you as opposed to against you. And the Eight of Wands talks about a flurry of communications, insights, guidance. Again, wands are about communication. Can be also represent like really, really fast progress. All of a sudden, if things have been dragging along, all of a sudden there's this like momentum. So what we're looking at here is, for whatever reason, you're looking at either or both, so having support of people around you And maybe one of those may refer you to some sort of a specialist, or recognizing that it's time to talk to somebody specific who has more knowledge in a certain area than you do. This is about the potential for growth, not only personal growth, but like not only tangible physical growth, but emotional growth. Knowing that you can control, you are able to keep it together, stay on top of things, make them all work. And once those ideas, those understandings have been reached and clarified, that's where you're going to start to see some really, really rapid movement going forward in terms of whatever this abundance is connected to, whatever kind of growth potential this is for you. So I really like the energy of these cards, but this really does feel like honestly, I want to say it's like time to recognize your strengths. It's time to know when you need help and know when you're good. Know what your goals are and what you're trying to give birth to, create, bring new. And then trust that when the pieces fall into place, there's going to be some real movement forward amongst a flurry of communications. All right. So. So, thank you very, very much for being here at Soulprint this week. I look forward to seeing you next week. Until then, enjoy the week ahead.